I'm lucky. I get to experience Star Citizen the way it's meant to be played. I get to experience it with the top-end hardware, on an ultra-wide monitor, with the best graphical settings the game provides, even enhanced with reshade. But that also is not only a good thing, it's a bit of a detriment as well. Now, this year really has been a standout one for Star Citizen, Cloud Imperium Games, and Chris Roberts especially. The money coming in is quite incredible. But this whole video is not just about where Star Citizen has been in 2020, and not just about 3.12, although we will be focusing on 3.12 as that is the current patch, and let's be honest, most of the beautiful, gorgeous visuals that you're seeing right now come from 3.12 and the work that was put into it. But it also, this video is going to be a good time to talk about the future of Star Citizen, and, you know, give you guys who are, again, still interested in the game, or those of you who are recurring players who want to see what it's like from Star Citizen's perspective, a bit of information. Why should you listen to me, though? Well, that's a very good question. Let's start by introducing myself. My name is Will, or Stewmeister, if you go and watch me on Twitch, or if you're familiar with my name here on the channel. Also, I go by the name Stewie over on Spectrum and in the game itself. I'm quite well known for, well, the more dubious aspects of the game. FPS combat, boarding, a bit of this and that. And I will admit, I do still hold the top tier trophy for Theatres of War. I did beat the leaderboard. And frankly, because you can't actually play the game mode, I'm going to hold on to that title as long as possible. But not only do I have a good background in the game, I have a good background, you know, in game design. In fact, I studied game art design, I studied graphic design, and, you know, I've worked a little bit in freelance photography and film, so that's why the visuals that you're looking at right now are so gorgeous and shiny. So, yeah, when I make points about the way the game looks and some things like that, I'm not just talking out my rear end, guys, I promise. There is some truth what I'm saying, and there is some experience to it as well. But what am I going to be talking about? Well, I'm going to be talking about the game, its current state, where I think it's going, my problems with it, what I really enjoy, what I think you guys should enjoy, what new players I think are going to enjoy, and what new players are going to be expecting. I'm also going to deep dive in some of the biggest problems, reoccurring, and obviously massively game-breaking. Some of them are just a bit more fun, like how overpowered the frag pistol is, for example. I'll talk a bit more about that later. But for a quick TLDR, for those of you who are more interested in that sort of content, the game is probably in the best playable state it has been in for a very long time. Granted, the Christmas patch was a little bit buggy, I think we can all agree to that. But overall, I think 3.12 is a fantastic time to get into the game, especially if you're just paying for that $45 game package. But also, it's a good time to come back into the game if you already have invested. So let's rewind a little bit and look back at 2020. The year has been full of surprises, both from SIG and from the community as well. Some fantastic numbers have popped in. We've got a lot more players. The game is also now more playable than ever before. I'm not going to dive too much into this because I have mentioned this in another video, but the game now has persistence in a way that's meaningful. You log in, you grind, you log out. Next day, you do the same, and eventually, you actually earn enough money to buy a ship in-game. Now, I purchased a 600i almost what feels like 8 months ago now, and I still have access to it. So we've not had a proper player wipe in a very, very long time. And I think that it just goes to show how hard SIG are working on iCache, the sort of things that we need in 2021 to really make the game we all want it to be. Personally, some of my greatest hits from this year has been the pure amount of changes to the game experience and, you know, the game life. So I did like the change to claim ship times and prices. I think that's a very good change. I liked the change to weapons, especially changing it from more gimbal loadout to a fixed oriented sort of competitive position. I also enjoyed the work they put towards mining, even though I wish they'd put some more work towards future coming stuff. Granted, this is all stuff if you do play the game, you'll experience with. If you're not playing the game, it doesn't really matter because you'll experience it when you do play. If you do play. But yeah, more on that later. It also was a year with some controversy, some decisions that we're not so happy about, and some major delays. We were promised Pyro as well as lots of other things from last year, and that just hasn't turned out. Unfortunately, that's the way the cookie crumbles. But the things that we did get truly do make up for a really fantastic experience. I mean, have you just seen these rocks? They're gorgeous. Look at the new details and the new graphics and the new sounds. I mean, the game right now, it just actually is really, really exciting to listen to and just look at when you're playing. It's far better than I would have expected. The new Talon ship, the Shrike or the Standard Talon, absolutely amazing. I mean, you can see them on screen now, but the sounds they make in game, I'm not going to spoil it for you here, but the sounds they make in game, they're just so good. So, all things considered, the new stuff that we got, including ships and gameplay features, all in all, actually makes the game a lot more enjoyable than it was last year. Oh, and did I mention head tracking? Yeah, head tracking is actually built into the game now, especially if you have a Tobii Eye Tracker 5. Now, I've had one for a long time. I was using Track IR to get it to work, but now that it's actually in-game, you can do so much with it, either in first person, in ship combat. It's a new feature to the game that works. Interesting, I know. And that brings me on to the unfortunate conversation about stability. 3.12, which is what this video is kind of mostly about, and also about 2021. 3.12 has been a bit of a mess. I'm not enjoying it, really. I get on, I play a few missions, they despawn or they don't load, or it takes literally about 10 minutes for a mission to load once I've reached the position. Really makes the grind not worth it. Not from an enjoyability standpoint anyway. Playing with friends is still definitely the way to go. So if you have friends and you want to play with them, do that. I can't guarantee that enough. You will have fun. Star Marine and the extra Arena Commander game modes that are outside of the PU also are suffering from tremendous, disgusting bugs. There's a horrible bug in Star Marine right now, which just has you murdered as soon as you spawn. It's actually horrible. It makes the game a misery to play. And Arena Commander has some obviously old existing bugs that just haven't been fixed, where you can't change your loadout, you can't rent new equipment. It's just, it's a mess in terms of stability for those aspects and bugginess. But this is an alpha, after all, even though it's, I will say right now that my personal opinion of the game and the game's marketing is that it is no longer an alpha and they are marketing it as a game experience. Sue me, but that's my opinion of it right now. And with all these horrible things said about the game, it doesn't mean I'm not having fun in those game modes. It just means that I could be having more. Star Marine is actually a game mode that I'm very well known for. It's what my, it's part of my passion in the game, considering it is FPS combat. I'm a huge fan of Star Marine. And frankly, I've found a way to have fun, and it's by using broken guns with broken metas, just destroying other people and embarrassing them. Sometimes even myself. It's just the way it is. And sometimes you have to find your own way of having fun in this game to truly take advantage of what the game has to offer you, because it doesn't serve it to you on a plate anymore. It used to be very simple. You knew what you could do and you knew what you couldn't do. You know, you'd go to a drug lab and you'd go and get shot by someone. They put that into the law, for Christ's sake. It's just the way the game was. But now the game is very, it's very self-sufficient. You have to go in there with an intention of something to do, knowing what it is you want to do, with goals you want to achieve. So if you don't go in without any, if you go in without any guidance or any objective, that's when you're not going to have fun. And if you're new to the game, let me give you some tips. So to make the most money in the game right now, you want to mine and you want to do some refining. That's the new thing in 3.12. You can use refineries. It's pretty cool. A bit simple, but pretty cool. It does let you have that sort of mechanized industrial feeling of taking one thing from one location and doing something with it and taking it from that location to the next and then selling it, and it's like being in industry. It's pretty cool. You can also do bounty hunting missions. They pay a lot more now, thank God, a lot more. There's also some very good secrets in 3.12 that even I haven't experienced yet. Capital ships, it's really, really, really cool. But whether it's worth it or not is up to you. Again, I'm completely transparent with how much I've spent on the game, and it is far too much. And would I say that the game is worth as much as I've spent on it? No. It's not worth that much yet. But it's getting there, slowly. And the reason for me saying that is actually because I don't think you need to spend lots of money anymore to have fun in Star Citizen. It is not pay to win. It never really has been, but it definitely isn't now. You can buy so much in-game now. Like, you can buy almost every single ship released in-game, and for relatively reasonable prices. The most expensive ship, I think, is like 30-something million, and once you make your first million, it then becomes so much easier to make the next and the next and the next. You could probably earn that in just a month. And to me, that's perfect. You don't want it to be too quick, you don't want it to be too long. And I guess that entire point segues nicely into what I'm going to say 3.12 really is. 3.12 is not a feature-rich patch, just like 3.11 wasn't. It's not a patch full of amazing, new, exciting stuff. It's just more of a sort of patch about the life inside the verse. It's a patch that fulfills some of the desires some players have had to expand on what we already have. Missiles, gunplay, sound design, mining, and, you know, transport missions. It expands on the basic normal missions with the sort of reputation system that is now in game, where if you complete a mission or if you fail to do a mission with some certain providers or from some people, you will get negatively or positively impacted by succeeding or failing. It's really nice life things that just improve the way everyday sessions turn out in Star Citizen and the feeling you get for just putting that time in. So, although I feel a bit like a stuck record, if you can put up with the bugs, the game is definitely worth playing. And again, it's more so worth playing bugs regardless if you have friends who do already enjoy it. It is difficult to get into right now, and if you are new to the game, I would say just wait maybe a week, maybe a month, just for the patch to be ironed out or 3.13 to come along. Join in again when it's free fly, test it on your machine, make sure it runs well, and then put the money down to buy it. And I say buy it because I do think this game is on sale and you're not really beta testing anymore. There is PTU, Evocati, Wave 1, Wave 2, Wave 3. The game is tested by plenty of players, so if you just want to play the game, it is in a playable state that you can have enough fun for $45 that I think is well worth it. Now, if you're wondering about performance, stay tuned on the channel for a future video. I actually am running the game right now on probably the best spec machine you can currently buy. It's a 5950X and a 3090, 32 gigs of RAM, all running on NVMe Gen 4 drives, all on a Gen 4 motherboard. Really, it's not something that the game was originally ever built to have to perform with, and somehow performance, as you'll probably see in a future video, not what you would expect. As far as expectations go, I hope this video is what you were expecting, something to really inform you about 3.12. Now, I know I didn't deep dive into anything particular. If you want the lowdown though, really, and abbreviations, the game is working, the game works well. The Salvo Frag Pistol is amazing. The new FS9 LMG is amazing. And they're the only two guns you should ever consider using, especially if you just want to win. Game modes like Star Marine and Marine Commander are functioning. They are functioning well enough to play. So don't expect them to be completely 100% reliable. The PU is again functioning enough to play. Don't expect it to be 100% reliable. And there is currently a PTU build that is promising to bring some fixes and bug-related crashes back down to a net zero, like 3.11 was, hopefully. And with 2021 in the future, we are expecting a heck of a lot more. Pyro, iCache, Crusader Industries Starlifter, Polaris, Redeemer, maybe even some more exciting new ships, which we just have no idea about. Hey, you don't have to actually invest to try all that out. You can just watch me live on Twitch. You can also just subscribe here on the channel. It really does mean a lot when you guys hit that like button and subscribe, because I do read the comments pretty much every day and check the stats. And frankly, I'm really excited about where this channel is going. We're not growing really fast, but we're growing, and that's important. I would like to hit 1,000 subscribers in 2021 at least, and I hope that you guys get more content that you deserve and that you really are excited about. I try my best to make content that is not only visually impressive, but also informative, educational, and something that raises questions and something that raises a discussion. So I don't just want to tell you the facts, I want to also have a conversation with you. So like I just mentioned, write a comment down below and let me know what you think, not only of this video, but of 3.12 and the patches coming in 2021, as well as what your favorite feature is in 3.12 and what you're most excited for in the future. I honestly want to know what you think, and I want to know what you think about this video. So please, again, hit the like button or the dislike button. If you didn't like it, you can always say send it to someone who you hate. That'll be amazing as well. Thank you again so much. I just want to say I am live on Twitch most days when I'm not working, and because I work retail, it is just very difficult. But I do try to get as much content up here on YouTube as possible. Some of it like this, and some of it just highlights from the stream. So if you have missed the streams live, feel free to watch the highlights. So goodbye, and thank you so much for watching. I hope you've enjoyed looking at the screen and hearing my beautiful British voice. I will see you guys all next time. So until then, goodbye for now.